Day 3 brings some good old text parsing and regular expressions. The text we will analyze mainly consists of rubbish, with some meaningful information here and there. We must isolate all substrings of this form. Each substring holds two numbers. Then we calculate the products of all such number pairs and sum them up. Regular expressions come to mind long before we end reading the requests. Here is the implementation class. I have already loaded the list of strings to process. We are good to go. This program will be surprisingly short. Most text parsing programs are short anyway. This extension method will process one line of text. A parsing method takes text as input and should return some structured data. That could be pairs of numbers we extract from the text. That is the whole point of parsing and nothing more. And then comes the implementation. That is where we meet the regular expression. You may watch my earlier video with tips on building a complex regular expression step by step. I will now construct a regular expression for all strings of this form. First, escape the parentheses literals. Match non-empty sequences of digits. Capture each number into a group. We need a way to access them later. It helps avoid processing mistakes if you give groups their names. The regular expression is complete. I can now subject the input text to the matches static method of the regex class. That will give me a match collection object which implements the IEnumerable of match. That makes it a subject to link. Each object in the sequence is a successful match. Turn each match into a pair of ints. Those two lines of code below are everything I need to complete this task. We need a sum of products, right? Apply parse to each line of text to obtain multiple pairs of numbers. Then calculate the sum of their products. It is done. I have completed the first part of the problem in only three lines of code. The second part will be more engaging. All requirements from the first part stay. We still sum the products. However, there are two new instructions. The don't instruction switches off the parsing of subsequent multiplication instructions. The do instruction switches it back on. Contextual processing is not the right job for regular expressions alone. We will need a bigger hammer. We cannot parse the text into pairs of numbers anymore. With no further delay, I will introduce the concept of instruction. The instruction is an abstraction. One variant is the multiply instruction, which we had already. The other two variants are to pause and to resume processing. I must augment the regular expression now with the do and don't instructions. Put the pipe operator and place the alternative. Then the other one too. But how will I know which of these was matched? You have already seen one viable solution to that problem. Just capture each of the keywords into a named group. When the match comes, we shall ask what is in it before proceeding. Capturing the don't group indicates the pause instruction. The do is the resume instruction. The remaining case is the multiply instruction as before. How shall I implement the summation of products now? The sum operator will not save me this time. I need something more powerful. The aggregate link operator will give me all the power I need. I will seed it with the sum set to zero and a switch set to true. That will indicate I should be including the multiply instructions for now. Then we accumulate the instructions one at a time. The behavior will depend on the type of the upcoming instruction. A pause instruction does not affect the sum, but indicates that we should ignore further multiply instructions. Resume does the opposite. It says we should continue processing multiply instructions again. Finally, we get to the multiply instruction. We only do what it says if the include flag is true. We add the product to the current sum. The remaining possibility is a multiply instruction we should ignore. So I ignore it. The overall result of the aggregate operator is the tuple. Take the sum with you and walk into the sunset. I can now complete the second part of this task. Start from the sequence of instructions. Subject it to the sum products method. It is over. The first part, however, is broken now. Just calling this all-powerful extension method would be wrong. The text might contain a don't instruction by accident. That would inadvertently affect the outcome. Link to the rescue. If I removed everything and only retained the multiply instructions, that would solve the first part of the problem, right? That completes the day 3 problem. You can download this code for free by visiting my Patreon page. There you will find a link to the repository where you can read solutions for all 25 days of Advent of Code 2024 for free. You can also stay around and watch more advanced videos on C# on my channel. We can now move to solving the day 4 problem.